Guys, today we're here on Dedrick Guy's account. He's got a bunch of scrolls. We're going to open them. It's nothing unusual for this channel. I did notice, though, that he's missing a lot of the meta. And I don't mean this because I know not everyone likes Lala and Friends as much as I do. I really like Lala and Friends. But I did notice that he's missing, like, Kali. He's missing Water Werewolf. He's missing Second Awakened Water Werewolf. This was, like, a thing that everyone had to at some point. Over like this 2-3 year stretch, it's like you had to use the Water Werewolf because that was just such an OP. I still think he's a good unit. I will still use him. I never stopped using him. But yeah, that was a very popular unit for quite a while. What else? He's missing this one. I mean, not everyone has that one built. There was something else that I thought was crazy that he didn't have built. I mean, this one's pretty good, but. Yeah, he's missing. Oh, maybe it was one of the elves. Oh, yeah! This! He doesn't have a Nashir belt. He doesn't have a Darien. It's crazy, man. It's crazy. What else is he missing? So many of these units were very, very popular. Maybe he doesn't have the units. Because I think that... Oh, he might actually not have some of these units at all. Hold on. He's definitely... He's missing some... He's never summoned a Dark Vagabond. Well, that's probably one of the reasons he didn't build it then. That would make sense. Because I think he did leave the game and then come back to it. After a while, what else? Okay, so he doesn't have a Shear. He doesn't have a Shear. He doesn't have Shren. He can't Second Awaken things he doesn't have. Right, that makes sense. Everything is falling into place now. That's crazy. Let's get him some of these units so he can actually finish playing the game. That seems ridiculous. He's missing some 4-stars. He's missing Soha. He's missing Tetra. He's missing, what is her name? Stella? He's missing, Jeez. He's missing Clara. You can get Clara from the guild shop. My mind is blown right now, guys. This is a fusion. Oh my god. I don't even want to see the runes on this account. But yeah, I think he left for quite a while and then came. He's missing a Shimite. Missing a Skog. Okay. So many good things we can get for him. He's only got a couple Nat 5s. I don't think that the blessing is going to be too crazy. Well, actually, maybe that means the blessing is going to be crazy, now that I think about it. There's going to be a lot of wins here. Well, maybe I shouldn't say that. There might be a lot of wins here. What is this? Oh, 30-day special benefit. Okay, yeah, like I said, that also adds to... he's got 2 Transcendent, 4 Witcher Scrolls, SWC, 4 Legendary Royal Tributes. He's got 19 Legendaries. He has 35 LDs. Let's get this started. We might be able to get some... Well, he doesn't have that many LDs. I really hope we can at least get him like a Shear and Shren and 3 LD5s. What do you have? 35 LD scrolls? Probably not going to happen. Probably not going to happen. All right, that might be not new, right? That's what I meant. Okay. Wow. Let's see what is on his wish list. Would love to get Fing Yan, Tiana, Odin, Moor, Ganny, Bastet, Adriana, Tashar, Diana, any Drew. I mean, we're just hoping to fill up some more of the Pokedex because you're missing so much at this. Oh, you're not the fire one. Ripperinos. We'll get plenty of the fire ones, I'm sure. Or maybe not. I don't know. Maybe we don't get the fire ones. It's easy enough to get. You get her from the guild shop. So. Shardine, any Druid, Sky Surfer, any Dragon Knight, any Monkey King. He's like, I want any units. I will take any units. Anything. Even some 3-star. Hey, that's good. That's good. That's good. Because we'll get you plenty of 3-stars. Don't you worry. Wow. There's so many opportunities to get him new stuff. I hope we at least get him good new stuff. I mean, the Water Werewolf, though, I'm surprised he didn't build that. Regardless, because it's easy enough to get. Right? Like Second Awakened Kali. Okay, here we go. I don't know why I'm saying here we go, but we're going somewhere. Any Dragon Knight, any Monkey King, honestly just fun units. What I really need are 4-star sculpts and a Shear from L&D. Yep, I agree. Would love a usable non-Hall Heroes LD4. Playing since 2017. Many long breaks. Many in all caps. I've been watching you this whole time, never saved enough scrolls until you announced Summoners for Retirement and decided I want to be on Saturday Morning Summit. Well, it's not Saturday. You know what that means. Blessing Party, use better judgment. Have never disagreed with a choice you've made. Never? You didn't watch enough videos then. I'm sure you would have had plenty of opportunities to disagree with plenty of things that I've said. Keep top tier dupes. I don't think he's gonna. I don't think we're gonna get very many dupes. We're gonna miss you, Bagel. Can't wait to see what you do next on YouTube. I mean, I'm still. I have other channels already, so it's gonna be just shifting attention to that. I am very curious what is gonna go on with what's gonna happen with my job, though. Not that they're gonna, you know. They're gonna fart me out, but what are the odds of this? What are the odds of 5 Wind Elven Rangers and 2 Wind Minotaurs? This feels rigged. Does this not feel rigged? Just to get so many of the specific, that's wild. That is very, yeah, that's very strange. Okay. Wind Yennefer. We're getting some new units. We do need some very meta new units for him. Although he's probably just going to take a break after this anyway. It's about that time. It's almost a Tuesday, so that's time to take a break for a year. How you not have the Water Werewolf belt? I should just keep his account for like another couple hours and finish this Water Werewolf. Be like, okay, he's built for you. You can actually use him now. I'm sure he didn't 6-star either. If it's not second, where am I looking? Where am I going? Some other things not built, of course. Water Werewolf. Not even remotely built. Such a good unit. But you built this! You built my Asura. No skill ups. I mean, it's hard to get scouts for that anyway. He's got more new. He's got the new units. Maybe he took breaks in the beginning and then, and he hasn't been taking breaks recently. I don't know. I don't know. I'm too tired to think. That's gonna be my excuse for everything now. Yeah, I'm trying to figure out what's going on with work, because I will need something to happen. Would be great. But I think a lot of people are in that spot right now, though. Tech industry is crazy. Really, really is. Water Vampire is a very good unit now. Not doo-doo like he used to be. Very, very solid. But yeah, there's so many people. It's probably a depressing conversation if I talk about so many people losing their jobs, and some of you guys are like, yeah, I'm one of those. Please don't talk about that. Yeah. But anything in that industry right now, it was a great thing to get back in there. Great thing. I left years ago and I didn't pick the best time to like, yeah, let's go back in the tech industry now that everyone's trying to downsize. Was such a smart idea on my part. Fire Stringmaster, brand new. But yeah, that will determine like what happens with work. Will determine what how much time that I spend on YouTube. Might be a lot. Might be the same. I would say that I'm still gonna try to get videos out like every day or two, regardless, on one channel or another. So. What else did he say? I've not had great summon luck over the years. Well, you take many breaks. But also, yeah, if you're still missing some 3-stars. I'm grateful to have you summon for me before you stop doing summon for videos. I've been free to play and never really consistent at the game until probably the last year or so. Okay, that makes sense. Tips on Necropolis team. My rage and will runes. You can even do if you're struggling with hell, you can with the Necropolis B12. You can still do B10. Like you'll still get runes from there that are usable. So you don't have to feel like you're forced. You won't get the intangible runes, but does he have Fire Bison? Is the question. If he has Fire Bison, then we know what the answer is. Let me just look here. No Fire Bison. This is an easy choice for me. I am very, yeah. Easy choice. I think this is a great unit. So, I think it's a great unit because it is a great unit. I thought he got crapped on in the very beginning. And then he got buffed, but it wasn't like a crazy buff, but everyone's like, oh my god, he's so good now. It's like, he didn't get that big of a buff, but you should have gave him a chance at the beginning, because he was actually not that bad. Yeah. I've been grinding giants, okay. There's plenty of new monsters I could use, and there's two transcendent scrolls. Praying you and your wife have an amazing week ahead. I don't know why I'm making that face. It's not anything exciting. So. Oh, wait a second. Fire. Nice. And another. Okay, so we got two brand new units. At least this Geralt is more useful than the Wind One. Wind One should get a buff of some kind. Well, let's see. There was a couple. Well, actually, there's some Steam games coming out, too. South Park Snow Day coming out this week. Very exciting. What day is today? Oh, yeah. I mean, you know what? By the time you're watching this, it might already be out. Because I don't know. Oh, Wind Gargoyle is a nice unit. AoE Provoke and does reflect damage based on his defense. So. Yeah, South Park Snow Day might be out at the time you're watching this. I really don't feel like it's going to be as good as the South Park RPG games. But I don't know what I feel about it in terms of, like, it could be garbage. It won't be as bad as the N64 one. That was pretty bad. But it won't be as good as the RPGs. It's going to be somewhere in the middle, but I don't know where in the middle. That's what I'm trying to say. It's going to be not here, not here, somewhere here. That's weird, right? That's weird. Fun with sound waves. What else is coming out? Avatar Realms Collide. Oh, we did talk about that. There's a couple of mobile games that are coming out that are somewhat worth maybe looking at. There's a game called Solo Leveling Arise, and I think that's based on an anime, right? Solo Leveling is an anime franchise. Looks like it could be pretty fun. For those of you that are interested in, kind of looks like Devil May Cry if it was an anime mobile. Kind of looks like an MMO. Is this action? Yeah, I guess like a third person ARPG anime meets Devil May Cry. I don't know. We might check it out. Aside from that, I don't know what else. Excuse me. What else is really worth talking about? God Sacrifice. It looks like a AFK idle game that plays itself. Skull the Hero Slayer. This one looks pretty cool. Graphically, it's a cute pixel art kind of thing. Metroidvania pixel art mobile game. Could be fun. Astra Knights of Veta. Looks like it's probably going to be garbage. I don't know. It just looks like that. We don't really know what people want art style. And not everything is really about the art style, but I kind of get the feeling that maybe that's an old game or something else going on. I don't think that one's going to do well. But South Park's no way. Excited to try that out. But I already spent my entire video game budget on 99-cent games. You blow your entire budget if you buy 1,000 of them at the same time. So that's just as Steve sale happened. And I was like, let's spend $1,000 on video games. I'm joking. I would not spend $1,000 on video games. Which is wild because when I was a kid, I think a lot of us probably went through this when we were kids. Is, well, the ones of us that didn't have crazy amounts of money from our parents to spend on video games. But, because I didn't have crazy amounts of money from my parents to spend on video games. So every once in a while, like if I worked for money, then I would have it. But I had all these lists. I would make lists when I was a child of all the games. As soon as I was older and I had money, all the games that I wanted to buy and then play. I'm going to have this game. I'm going to have that game. I'm going to have the other game. I'm going to have the little thing that goes on the game to make the game cooler. And I didn't. And the things that I did buy, I never got a chance to play. So, yeah. But the lists, maybe one day if I have so much money that I have no idea what to do with it, maybe I'll still probably not buy them. Still probably not. Man, those lists, though. Jeez. I would write very detailed lists and like the orders that I was going to get them in. I'm like, okay, I'm going to get this summer job. I'm going to make this money. I'm going to do that. Motivated by material possessions. The American way. What else? You really don't need crazy amounts of games, though. Like, I'm sure you guys know that, but it really just all boils down to like, get the games that you're going to enjoy playing the most and then play those. You don't need to own 5,000 things. You don't need to own 5,000 different games. I say this after I bought all the, you know, put 20 games on the Steam. So I bought 20, but it's like they were super cheap. So was it 15 or 20? I don't know. I don't think there was anything over like $5 though. A couple of them were under $1. So actually, like half a dozen of them were under $1. So it's not. Oh, Juno. Is this new? It is new. Very nice. Very nice. All fire units, though. Well, now he's going to have an issue after that. He's got a very unbalanced account now. Congratulations. He's got the units that do the AoE debuffs, and then the unit that counters the AoE debuffs. Not bad. Juno is, I kind of feel like we should ruin them for him. Because I'm like, man, I don't know if he's going to mess these up or not. I'm sure he'll ruin them right. I say that, but I've seen so many accounts where people run things crazy. She's so good, though. She is one of my favorite, one of my most picked units. I've seen worse. Maybe I haven't seen worse. Maybe we don't ruin Juno, because I don't know that there's going to be the runes for Juno on this. Revenge is nice on her. Violent Revenge. I like crit rate, but yeah. All right, maybe we don't ruin Juno. You don't need violent on this, actually. The reason that I say this is you can, if you're limited on a certain rune set, you can. Oh, Shimite! Finally. It's only been 7 years. 7 years, no Shimite. That's crazy. Shimite, Ashir. If we get him a Ashir, I really hope we get him an Ashir. At the very least, Ashir and a good LD4. Because, you know, we're not going to get an LD5. Maybe two good, hopefully two good LD4s. Hopefully. At the very least, we need an Ashir. We really do. I'm still mind blown. No Ashir, no second awakened Kali, no second awakened werewolf. That's wild. Okay, new unit. Oh, no new unit. Okay. We already got that. So, four more Nat 5s would be nice. We're definitely getting two because, you know, Transcendence. Would be great to get, I kind of want five. We're not going to get five. We're not going to get five. What other games coming out this week? I saw them. Maybe we just do a video on the other channel about them. Even though no one has been watching those videos anyway. I shouldn't say no one. Some people have. But yeah, it's not not everyone's cup of tea. This game looks like Disney Dreamlight Valley. It kind of does. It's called Palia. Vibrant new world made for you. Craft, cook, fish, and farm with friends as you live the life of your dreams. And discover an enchanting adventure filled with colorful characters and a mystery to unravel. This looks like Disney Dreamlight Valley. From what I've seen of Disney Dreamlight Valley, I haven't actually played the game, though. Ender Magnolia Bloom in the Mist? I kind of like this art style. Looks kind of cartoony, but also dark at the same time. It's a Metroidvania game. Looks like demonic a little bit. Go fight fantastic. I can't really communicate the art style of some of these games, and a lot of them are very, very different to without seeing them. That's always been the situation trying to do these summon videos and talking about other games. It's like, we don't know what you're even looking at, and also we don't care because Summoner's War is the only thing that I'm interested in. Yep. All jokes aside, because I know, like, from my perspective, I'm like, oh man, it sucks to hear about, like, all the people complaining about the things that I'm talking about on videos. Well, some people like them, some people don't. But, you know, that is something to take into consideration for YouTube, because so many people make this mistake, so many YouTubers make this mistake of, they're like, I'm going to do variety, I'm going to be a variety YouTuber and a variety streamer, I'm going to just do whatever I feel like doing, and like, that is the worst idea you could possibly have. That is the absolute nail in the coffin for any YouTube channel. You are dead before you even start. Like, if you're going to do variety, because then the algorithm does not know what you are trying to do. They do not know who to share your video to, your videos to. Ooh, Outpost Infinity Siege. This is a first-person shooter. Looks pretty nice, actually. Yeah, I think a lot of people are going to be playing this on Twitch. Graphics look solid. Oh, it's not a first-person? It's a first-person shooter that also has RTS elements? Command mobile outpost and take Zenfarm to venture deep into the Signet surveillance off-limit area. I don't know what any of that means. Collect unique weapon units. Aim up the firepower of the outpost that fights with you. This is an FTD game. FPS, tower defense, base building, and much more at the same time. Okay, so similar to what I said. What did I say? FPS and RTS? Yeah. Interesting, though. Oh, there's a new Age of Empires mobile game that's coming out, but I don't have very high hopes for it. It's going to appeal to a very niche group that are playing, you know, strategy games on mobile and are comfortable spending $50,000 on a phone game. So. It's going to be one of those games where they're perfectly fine having a lot of people try it and then 90% of them leaving and then having like a player base of 10,000 that spend money to smack each other with their e-peens, I suppose. It's a good way of explaining it. Good old e-peen smacking. That's kind of Summoner's War, though. If you think about it, people just spend a whole bunch of money to smack each other with their e-peens. Now we need one more. I don't want to do this for. Yeah, let's go. Can we grab? There we go. Almost to the LDs. Well, we basically are at the LDs. We really need. This could be game changing. I mean, Ashir is pretty big, right? So. We don't have any Megans to jiggle. Oh, jeez. On the bright side, at least he has the, at least he has these. All right. 35 LDs. Bounty Hunter, that is not new. Lizardman. Light Minotaurus, new unit. Not a fan. Light Griffin, well, he already had that one. He doesn't have the Dark Griffin. Dark Harg, that's a pretty nice one. Okay. Champion. Dark Amazon. Okay, so we finally got a Shren form. Very nice. Very nice. Light Warbear. That's a secret dungeon, though. There's no excuses to not have that. Light Amazon. Okay. We're getting a lot of new things for him. Very nice. Still need a Shear, though. Dark Marshall Cat. Okay. It didn't show new, right? Dark Epicon Priest. Really need a Shear. No LD Lightning. All right. Okay, here's the LD Lightning as soon as we complain about it. All right, is this... I would assume this is a dupe. This is new. There was a Hall of Heroes for that. But he did say he left the game for a while. He took many breaks. Light Mummy. Okay, we're getting new stuff. The Ashir, the lack thereof Ashir, is kind of rough, though. Okay, second LD Lightning. Watch LD5. Okay. Nice new 4-star Magic Archer. Imp Champion, Light Imp Champion. Not a crazy unit, though. Really, really hope we get a Shear. Light Living Armor. Dark Viking, but another one that's a... I mean, it's a fusion, but also it's a secret dungeon. Still no Ashir. Another Dark Viking. Grim Reaper. Last chance. Battle Mammoth. No Ashir. Still no Ashir. That's wild. All right. Well, hopefully he gets it soon because that's a kind of a necessary... It's not necessary, but man, it's... Like, I feel a Shaman is actually necessary, right? Light Griffin is actually necessary. But Ashir is just like, it's rough to try to play the speed game without Ashir. But I don't think he would have the runes for Ashir anyway. He said he's been farming giants, but he's taken so many breaks. So. So he probably does not have the runes to be able to... reliably outspeed things with Ishir. Ishir would be the let's try to get to 300 speed unit. Not the we already have 300 speed on a unit that has low base speed. Let's put him on Ishir and then we can get to 320, 330, something like that. So I was hoping we were going to get another net 5. Oh, speaking of, and of course it's a fire one. Of course. This is a dupe. Wait, which one does he have? Okay, so he has this the same one. Wow. So many units he's missing, and he actually does wind up getting a dupe. Why can I never find these buildings? It's wild that we are using... Yeah, let's get some LD scrolls. I like to get those devil mons from that. I mean, at least the rates weren't terrible, though. We got him a handful of new units that he's going to be able to... they're going to make a difference to his game, but... Well, new over dupe, and of course, it is another fire unit. I wonder if we'll get any from any other element. Why does this feel rigged? All fire units. At least we're getting stuff. Skogel, and this is new, because he has not had a Skogel before. That's wild. That is wild. I don't even play with Skogel anymore. I don't play with Skogel, and I have many. Many of that. Yeah, I have, what, 6 Skogels, something like that? I got a bunch. It's been a while. I mean, aside from, there's like teams to auto that he's in, but, so I suppose I have technically played with him, but. And of course, it's another fire unit. Is this new? Yes, this is new. It's all fire. Oh my god. Nothing of any other element. Only fire. Jeez. By the way, that Counter Girl is a great unit. Definitely would recommend building. As you were talking about Necro. That is a must-have unit for Necro. That one. And also... Oh, here's another. And it's another fire unit, of course. Of course. Every single unit we've gotten here is a fire unit. Is the last one that we are Leo would be nice. Yeah, Leo would be nice. I know one wants the Laika, but now what are these 4 stars? I want to kind of try to get him things that he does not have. The others, these are fusion units, so. It's weird to have Clara in here. And another fire net, but I don't know. Okay. Water Assassin. How many more fire units can we get from here? Alright, Fire Siri, all jokes aside, is another fire unit. It's not a nat 5, but. Yeah, let's see. Okay, Wintress. It only counts. The meme only counts if it's a nat 5. All right, man. They all look so similar, even with the changes. Even though Comptro was like, we're gonna make them look a little bit more different. Still look exactly the same. Okay, this is a light one. Light Yennefer, very nice. So 4 legendary all attributes. Is it? Should we? I feel like we should do this. Maybe. What did he say? He said something. St- headphones. No, we're not doing stones. Okay. Well, the opportunity is there, if you would like. Four legendary attributes. Okay, it's a fusion unit, but at least you don't have to fuse it, I suppose. The fire, Dokebi princess. Okay, we got, oh, we're just getting all fusion units, all right. Right. So, the real question is, these two transcendents, are they both fire? How many is he missing? So he can get a fire Yennefer. I'm just trying to see if we should maybe not summon on that, there's some duds in there. Maybe we shouldn't do these, whatever, we'll do it. We'll do it. Let's see. Which one? Oh, not a fire unit. Well, the streak is over, guys. Wind Puppeteer, great unit, though. Great unit. Very, very solid unit. Very, gets ridiculous sometimes. And, of course, a Fire Nora. A Fire Nora, Fire Totemist. This, I think, as I saw that he had Rika on his wish list. I think that this is a better than Rika. I'm terrible, I know. Wonderful unit. Very, very, very wonderful unit. So, I really like the Fire Totemist. Basically, infinite strips into dots into extra damage based on the dots. It's a wild unit. It really is. And this is kind of a cheat code for Punisher script. So, there you go. I don't know if I'm sure he doesn't have a Punisher script team built. If he's taking a bunch of breaks from the game. But I think it's a nice cheat code for that. Oh, he does. I see you might have watched someone's video using these. Yep. Feels like it. All right, guys. Anyway, that's it for this one. Because we did a video how these were like the easy cheese way of. And I'm sure that this is going to be. This is going to find its way into that team. So anyway, that's it for this one. Hope you guys enjoyed. I hope you guys get some good summons for yourself this week. I will see you as always in the next one.